Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and hospitality simple. Do you want your silverware drawer to be neat and orderly, but it's not quite there yet? Is it filled to the brim, but you don't have a matching set when friends come over for dinner? Well, in this video, I'm going to share 3 tips on how to organize your silverware drawer. I'm standing in my kitchen, and against this wall, obviously, is my microwave and stove. All these drawers hold utensils and silverware and things for cooking. I like to keep the countertop open, and then above the cabinets, I do store some things. Those are things that I use when I am entertaining. Here to the left are this air garden that my friend gave me for my birthday, and then this tray and my favorite sign from Hobby Lobby, if you feed them, they will come. By the way, this is fantastic. I harvested mint and chives yesterday. It grows really fast. My first tip on how to organize your silverware drawer is to choose a drawer near where you eat. So that is the drawer, and then this is our kitchen nook, and you can see that it is the closest drawer to this table. You want to choose the drawer closest to where you're going to eat, or at least close to it, versus the opposite side, because it's going to be more convenient and easier for you to set the table or whoever has that chore. My second tip is to use drawer organizers. Now, I have seen silverware drawers and utensil drawers where there's no type of organizer. There's no utensil organizer, there's no drawer organizer, there's nothing, and so it's all swimming around. Here I've used acrylic organizers in a rectangular shape, and I have shelf liner there. I've labeled each one like that. Small forks, teaspoons, forks. This says spoons. This one says butter knives and spreaders. This one underneath says steak knives. Okay. This says soup. Or labeled. They don't actually say anything. This one has chopsticks and chopstick rests. You also want to measure before you buy the bins. I measured the silverware themselves and got the right size for the containers. And you want to have ones that are going to fit your drawer as best as possible so that you don't waste any space. Now let me show you this drawer with the same configuration for my silverware, but without the organizers. Okay, it looks a little bit neat, but once you open it up and close it a few times during the day, it's going to be moving around. And so that's why you need drawer organizers. And then how about when you've used them all and now you go to put them back in place, going to be a lot easier for you and your family members to know exactly where to put them. My third tip is to have your silverware in complete sets of 6. I do that because a table usually has seating for 6 people. Mine are a set of 12, and that's because I have my kitchen nook and then I have my dining room table. So when I have a dinner party, I know that I always have 12. And I can make 2 complete table settings. My first tip is to choose a drawer near where you eat. Second tip is to use drawer organizers. And the third one is to have complete sets of 6. Question of the day, how many complete sets of silverware do you have in your silverware drawer? I'd love to know in the comments below. I read all your comments and reply to them. If you're new to this channel and you want more home organizing and hospitality tips, then hit the subscribe button and the bell notification, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought would never pay the price.